Students, now today in the last segment of this chapter we will discuss the given problems of exercise 4.4. So students, as we know that the nature of roots depends on the discriminant b square minus 4ac, right? As we already discussed, the nature of roots depend on the discriminant. If it is greater than 0, we have two real distinct roots. If it is less than 0, there is no roots. And if it is equal to 0, the equation have two real and equal roots. Right? I repeat again, if b square minus 4ac, discriminant is positive, we have equation, a quadratic equation have two distinct real roots. If it is negative, b square minus 4ac is negative, the quadratic equation have no real roots, because the under root, square root of b square minus 4ac is the imaginary value. Yes or no? And please take care, in discriminant, only b square minus 4ac, the value of b square minus 4ac is known as discriminant. It is not under root b square minus 4ac. Please take care, because so many students get the error and always calculate under root b square minus 4ac. That is wrong, because discriminant is only b square minus 4ac. Okay, now let's start our exercise 4.4. The question number 1 totally completely based on this b square minus 4ac discriminant, and we need to find out the nature of roots. Equations are given here. The first equation, you can easily calculate b square minus 4ac by using the coefficient of x square, x and constant value a, b, c respectively. Yes, so I take the second part here, question number 1, second part, and first we calculate b square minus 4ac and see that what will we get. What is a here? A is equal to 3. What is b here? B is equal to minus 4 under root 3. And what is c here? C is equal to 4. Right? So how we calculate b square minus 4ac? Take minus 4 under root 3 whole square minus 4 into a into c. What will you get? If you multiply 4 under root 3, 2 4 under root 3, what will you get? 4 4 is 16. 16 into 3. Because negative negative, it becomes positive. And 16 into 3 is what? 48. Again, look, 4 is 12, 12, 4, 48. It means what? It means 0. Here, the b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. It means the equation have two real equal roots. And the roots are what? Minus b upon 2a and minus b upon 2a. So what is minus b? B is here. Minus already. Minus here already. 4 under root 3 upon 2 into a. 3. Yes? It means what? 2 under root 3 upon 3. Or we can write 2 upon under root 3. If we convert this 3 as under root 3 into under root 3, we can write what? 2 upon under root 3. Okay, so 2 upon under root 3, 2 upon under root 3, both roots are equal here. So I hope you understand how we find out the nature of roots of the given quadratic equation, and if it is possible, then we can easily find out the roots by using quadratic formula. Okay, well, now question number 2. Question number 2. Here in question number 2, we need to find out the value of k if the equation have two real equal roots. Again, the condition given here that the both the equations given here are having two real equal roots. It means what? It means b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, because it is given that they have two equal roots. Yes. So in the very first part, what is a here? A is 2. B is equal to what? K. And C is equal to what? 3. So by using this relation, because it is given that the equation have two real equal roots, we use the equation a square minus 4 into a into c, that is equal to 0. So what will we get? A square minus 4, 8, 24. Yes or no? 4 to 8, 24. That is equal to 0. Or how we calculate this k is equal to k square is equal to 24, and by taking square root we get k is equal to plus minus under root 24. Yes or no? Whenever taking a square root, you always get two values. One is positive and another is negative. So that is the value of k. And I hope you similarly you can find out the value of k in the second part. The second part given here. Yes, students. So the next question we take here, that is question number 3. So please read the question number 3 and here we solve question number 3. It is possible to design a rectangular mango grove whose length is twice its breadth and the area is given 800 meter square. Students, here we have a condition between length and breadth of the rectangular mango grove. So let's check if it is possible or not. First we'll add the breadth, that is equal to x meter, right? So according to the condition given here, length is what? Length is equal to twice x, yes or no? Because it is given length is twice its breadth. And you know that what is the area of rectangle? Area of rectangle, that is equal to length into breadth. And here we have x into 2x, length into breadth, and it is given here 800. So what will we get? Twice x square is equal to 800, or x square is equal to 400? Yes or no? So what will we get? X, it's a perfect square number. If we take a square root here, what will we get? Plus minus 20. Yes or no? Plus minus 20. And you know that we never take a length or a breadth negative. So x is equal to 20 meter. If x is equal to 20 meter, it means breadth is equal to 20 meter, then 2 into x, the length will be 40 meter. It means it is possible. Or you can see, find out the b square minus 4ac here. We can find out the b square minus 4ac by using this equation. Here we get x square minus 400 as a quadratic equation, and here we can also find out b square minus 4ac. And let's check what will we get b square minus 4ac. What is a here? B is what? B is what? B is 0. That's why 0 square minus 4 into what is a? A is 1, and c is minus 400. C is what? Minus 400. So what will we get? B square minus 4ac is equal to 4 for the 16 and minus minus plus the 1600. Yes or no? Yes or no? It means b square minus 4ac is greater than 0. So it is possible and the equation have real roots. Yes or no? That's all about the question number 3. Similarly, in the question number 4, again check that the given condition is possible or not by using the b square minus 4ac. Is the following situation possible? Question number 4. Determine their present age. If the sum of the ages of two friends is 20 years. Sum of the ages of two friends is 20 years. 4 years ago, the product of their ages was 48 years. 48 years. So if we let the age of one friend, that is X. First friend came X years later. Okay. Let the age of first, present age of first friend, that is X years. So according to the question, the second friend age kya ho jayegi, because the sum is what? 20. That's why 20 minus x years. Yes, yes or no? Now, 4 years ago, what will be? What was the 4 years ago? The age of first friend. 4 years ago, the age of first friend, that is x minus 4 years, and the age of second, the first, that is 20 minus x minus 4, that is equal to 16 minus x years. I hope you understand. Now apply the condition given here. Product of these two, the age of these two, x minus 4 and 16 minus x, that is equal to given 48. Now solve the bracket. 16x minus x square minus 64 minus minus plus 4x, that is equal to 48. Now solve the like terms. What will you get? Minus x square, and solve this 4x and 16x plus 20x. Now convert here to minus 112, that is equal to 0. And if we multiply the whole equation by minus 1, what will we get? We get x square minus 20x plus 112 is equal to 0. Now students, here we need to calculate b square minus 4 as a discriminant, so that we can find out which type of roots it have, right? So calculate the discriminant. What is a here? 1. What is b here? Minus 20. And what is c here? 112. So b square minus 2 minus 4 into 8 into 8. Right? So what will we get? 408 minus 20 into minus 20, 400. 112 multiplied by 4, minus 448, and that is equal to minus 48. It means it is less than 0. B square minus 4ac here, less than 0. It means what, students? The equation have no real roots. It means the condition, the given situation is not possible. Understand what I'm saying? Right. So I hope you understand how we calculate b square minus 4ac and find out the nature of roots and check whether the given conditions, whether the given situation are possible or not. And one more last condition given here in the question number 5. Again, the rectangular path is given. Perimeter of 80 meter and area is 400 meter square. It is given here. So let with the length and breadth of the path. Question number 5. Let karo length and breadth. That is length L and breadth B. Okay. So what is given here? It is given the perimeter, means twice into L plus B, that is equal to 80. It is given. It means what? It means length plus breadth, that is equal to 40. It is for our first condition. Yes or no? Right? And what is the second condition given here? Area. Area is what? Length into breadth. It is given. So length into breadth is what? L into B. It is given what? 400. So can we use the value of length or breadth from equation 1 and by equation number 2, right? Use breadth is equal to 40 minus length. Can we write b is equal to what? 40 minus length, and put the value here in equation number 2. So length into 40 minus length, that is equal to 400. Yes, it is given. Now use 40L minus L square is equal to 400. It means what? L square, both transfer both here. L square, or you can say L square minus 40L plus 400 is equal to 0.
Now you can easily calculate b square minus 4 is here. What is a here? 1, b here minus 40, and c is what? 400. Because here the equation in the alpha, the variable l, length, right? So what is b square minus 4 is c? Please calculate b square minus 4 is c. B square minus 4 is c. What is b? Minus 40. Minus 4 into a into c is what? 400. So students, 40 square, 1600. Minus 1600. It means 0. It means what? It means the equation has real and equal roots. Two real and equal roots. It means this situation is possible and we can easily calculate the dimensions. What is the if b square minus 4 is equal to 0, that time what is root? Roots are minus b upon 2a and minus b upon 2a. So you can easily calculate what is minus b here. B is what? Minus 40. So minus minus 40 upon twice into 1, that is 40 upon 2, that is equal to 20 meter. Yes or no? If the length क्या हो जाएगी 20 meter, again 40 minus 20 कर लीजिए आपने, again 20 meter. It means length and width both are 20 meter. It means it is a square. It means it is a square rectangular piece, square part. Okay students. So this is all about exercise 4.4. Thanks.